John was a good man. Even Jesus was endorsing him. But even good people go through bad times. I don't know about y'all, but that's so good for me to know. I said, that's good for me to know, because if I don't know that and I start going through bad times, then I think I'm a bad person. But that ain't what it says. No, even good people will go through bad times. John was a wonderful man. He was just having to survive a horrible season. And I don't care who you are, when life puts the squeeze on you, whatever is in you is going to come out. Whether it's pretty, whether it's ugly, whether it's nice, whether it's mean, it's going to come out. Opinions you thought you would have never had. Thoughts you thought you would have never thought. Conversations that you would have never gotten caught up in. See, pressure on the outside is what causes the frustration that's on the inside to be made manifest, which is really, it's really okay, because I personally am persuaded that you cannot see how great God is until you get in the middle of some hellfire and brimstone. You don't know how big God is until you get in a little bit of trouble, because you cannot perceive the greatness of God just by counting your blessings. You perceive the greatness of God by counting the burdens that He's enabled you to carry, because His strength is made perfect in my weakness. Sickness will cause you to know that there is a healer in your life. Worry will cause you to know that there is a comforter. Oh, ain't nothing like God walking into your bedroom at 2 o'clock in the morning saying, oh, live and not die. It's gonna be all right. I didn't bring you this far to leave you. When you go through the flood, when you go through the fire, I'll be right. John was a good guy going through a bad season. He was a good guy and was going through a bad season. And so that didn't surprise me, because we all go through rough seasons. What does surprise me is that John was Jesus' forerunner. So when they went and told Jesus, hey, your buddy is in jail. What does surprise me is that he didn't just say, where? Take me to where he is. Show me where John is. No, he didn't go. He just sent a message. See, some of y'all get mad because the pastor don't come to the hospital to see you. He said, go back over there and tell John. Tell him that the lame are walking. Tell him that the blind are seeing. Tell him that the lepers have been cleansed. Tell him that the deaf are hearing. Tell him that the dead are getting back up again. Tell John that the gospel is being preached to absolutely all of them. See, you know what Jesus was doing? He was letting his fruit do the talking. He was letting his fruit do the talking. You ain't got to tell everybody who you are. Just let your fruit do the talking. Woo. He said, go over there and tell John that I said, wherever I am, it has, tell John that wherever he is, it has absolutely nothing to do with where I am, because I am God. I am God Almighty. There's no God beside me. There's no God like me. Tell John, hang in there, buddy, because there are benefits to carrying burdens. Tell John that my strength will be made perfect in his weakness. Tell John that if I got ready to get him out of there, I still wouldn't have to come. I'd just speak one word and everything that had him tied up would have to let him go. Well, I want to tell somebody in this room today, if you are in a fight that will not stop, if you can't pray it away, if you can't fast it away, if you can't believe it away, trust me when I tell you, at the end of the day, it's when that gets in the basement of your spirit, like Job, you